You know what you can also
surprise?
You can also orb if you miss the block, so you can get the block off. It's actually, I think, that important that you might need to do
so, it. So you jump in front again. Hmm.
I think you, like, if you're puck mid, you definitely skill orb so you can block after the bounty rune. In 1v1, maybe a little bit different. Neither person has skilled yet. I'm not sure about level 1 fascia. I think level 1 fascia is also pretty good too, though, because you can evade a lot of right clicks. But it doesn't help you CS. So where do you go with this? There's a lot of different ways, and this is probably not one that's played that often anymore because Puck is not really seen as a mid laner.
Yep. The difference between our items is two branches versus the early tangos of Paparazzi.
So tangos means you're going for harassing as opposed to CSing. Because if you're going for CSing, you want maximum damage and perhaps maximum mana, although mana isn't your limiting factor. It's mostly right clicks. So I think he's actually going to play very aggressively on Miracle, perhaps with Orb level 1, or even Silence level 1. Silence level 1 sounds awful, but I think it's either Orb level 1 or Facial level 1.
How do you keep the aggression up, though, without the lane punching back? Because you've still got to move back off the lane to consume the tango. If the lane
maybe you
slow,
bait a branch play by Miracle and then steal it.
And then you're right, no. If that happens, like if that actually
so
happens,
sick.
It would be.
Have you seen that in mid before? Like people try and pop a tango and then it gets like power shotted down really fast. Those are some sick plays. I love seeing those. Okay, here we go.
Miracle's lost another creep. It's the melee who moves forward, but it's not as bad a position as before.
Okay, let's see who skills
it's still
what
on the hillside
first.
Of Paparazzi.
Both
so Miracle. Phase. It's both dodging with phase shift. So when he's straight physical harass, he can at least dodge one of the attacks.
He already ate a tango, though, so that's pretty good. Miracle has zero CS so far. Okay, there he goes. One.
Well, Salve and Salve, I think, are on the way out. Miracle needed to have the regen.
The range creep deny. Oh, here we go. that's good. That's good for Paparazzi. You don't get it denied. That's a victory. And this range creep, is it going to get denied? Oh no, Miracle doesn't have orb yet.
He didn't want to face shift either. Paparazzi actually shifts himself up on the hillside, pushing Miracle away from the range creep. And that range creep is one more attack for Paparazzi. Is two attacks away from denial.
You can also get courier snipes in 1v1.
Because you can all forward. Miracle. Well, the phase shift's down for Paparazzi, so Miracle wants to try and commit here. He potentially could, and he does. He jumps down. The ult from Paparazzi will hit. He already took the damage and then jolts up the river and away. Now, he doesn't have a salve. It's in his stash. The courier has to bring it back out again, so it's only the consistent regeneration to put it back. And Miracle's doing the same thing. He did actually buy a salve for his first time around. He bought the tangos instead.
Paparazzi has to wait for that slow chicken, only close to the T2. Miracle could play pretty aggressively up here, close to the T1 tower. T1 dive is not as big of a deal because of your puck. You have two ways to dodge, one with a jaunt, one with a phase shift, and that should generally be enough to secure a first, but if you're confident enough in your play. So he goes for 2 points into the orb. You're generally using your orb a lot more than your silences, but if you can get a silence off and prevent like two dodges, one with a jaunt,
You can see Miracle like he's getting into position for this. I guess suppose the orb coming from a tree line's got a higher chance of connecting. Okay, Paparazzi jumps out. Remember that creep wave's gonna be there, but the silence, the only point up from Paparazzi. Miracle, he's got phase shift back off cooldown. He can dodge the attack and keep his salve going. So Paparazzi can't put in that little bit of damage he wants to stop Miracle, but he does do the tango trick.
That's a lot of mana to commit. Miracle only had to commit like 100 mana versus 180 for Paparazzi, so. He did actually get the kill with the Waning Rift, so it might not be that great for him at this point in time. Miracle, I would be very surprised if he didn't take Waning Rift at level 4.
Well, what's he sitting at? We'll have to wait a little bit longer. But 12-3, 12-3, a lot closer on the CS this time around. Miracle not losing control as Puck.
Yeah, this is dead even.
However, I think a lot of those deniers which have come from Paparazzi have been the range creeps.
Yeah.
Is he? Okay, Miracle's purposely taking the damage and keeping the creep wave up on his side of the hill.
Both players doing the same old loop-de-loop.
Well, it's this mirror mirror. It's like we're watching Night Elf versus Night Elf right now.
Man, pucks were OP. Nether flare.
Classic. Anyway. Face shift, face shift, face shift dodge.
Oh.
Miracle's able to connect, however, on the orb. So extra consumables being burnt by Paparazzi this time around, as opposed to the other way around.
Oh, the silence committal too. He's not doing too well in the management department. Did he go? Oh, he went for two waning rift. Oh, this is big.
He's actually doing what you were talking about.
He could commit.
But the opposite way from Miracle is this 2-1-1 build from him.
you're just able to cast orb a lot more often. You can get a lot more harass now. When you bait out a phase shift like that, you can connect with an orb and consistent whittling down. Miracle's very healthy in terms of HP.
He's actually got paparazzi so low. But his orb was still on cooldown, so he couldn't commit again.
Drop the selves, backpack them, do something. Oh, the efficiency.
The nulls. Oh. Yeah, he's holding onto them. There's no efficiency coming out from this man. Now the orb dodged by Miracle. Oh, he actually chaunted. He went over there. Now the warning rift is there from paparazzi. He'll commit that, but miss the target. He wanted to strand Miracle on the radiant side of the river, and it won't work. And now Miracle is just beating into him.
Level 6 is actually not that important here, because you can just... actually, it is pretty important, because if you can catch him after the jaunt, then it's pretty big, but otherwise...
How does that synergy work? Like, when you orb out, like, and you jaunt, you're still going to get triggered by the Dream Call? Like, there's no way to dodge it?
Yeah, but it doesn't matter that much. I mean, you can just stay in and just tank with Waning Rift. That's the thing. Like, if you're stronger in the straight right-click war, then Dream Coils, you don't have to run away. Sit there. No biggie.
Miracle again with a phase dodge.
So still very even. Both heroes sitting at 22 CS. The clarity gets popped. The range creep. Okay, who's closer to 6, actually? Paparazzi is slightly behind. So we're talking about 5 and like 6/10 versus 5 and...
There's really not that much difference between them at the moment. You do have a little bit more of a wave for paparazzi.
1-3-1 versus 2-2-1. The silence time is actually pretty significant, I would say, in this particular match. 2.25 doesn't sound like that much, but that 0.75 second, like, it could prevent you from jaunting all the way back.
He's still going to find the perfect moment against Miracle, so Miracle can ult forward, actually lets his own silence go. Paparazzi is not healthy.
He was about to dumpster him with a double combo, though, if Miracle stayed in melee range with a silence, so you can guarantee that the jaunt is going to hit, or that the orb is going to hit.
And they're both having to burn their salves.
Did Miracle commit for a second? No. Boots are not that important in this matchup, because it's all... Oh my god, there's three creeps there!
He actually goes for the ulti and the silence! There's nowhere for Miracle to go! This could be it, the orb away! The damage is not enough to kill him! Miracle will survive the one charges. Help keeping him above the threshold, and he gets back behind the tier one.
Paparazzi just creates a lot more opportunities in this. He's not going to pre-eat a tango. Miracle, very, very low. Where are the chicken at?
It's coming. It's at the tier 3 tower at the moment. We need to almost have like courier cams like permanently up next to the players at the moment. But Miracle.
Oh, what did he skill at 6?
He got 2-3-1.
Okay. Interesting. All these skill builds. Miracle. That Dream Coil was almost game winning.
Yeah.
Almost series winning and trophy winning. He's that close, 1-0, as we see in the top ticker.
And you're starting to see the difference now with the CS too. Like, Miracle had to burn through a hell of a lot before. Gonna orb through the wave, so he loses the momentum too. But 33-12 against the 27-7. That's probably the biggest distance we've seen in difference in CS.
Definitely. Again, Paparazzi just identifying this tiny opportunity to go for a big play, even despite being slightly behind in terms of CS and in terms of HP and mana. He went for the kill build, though.
Does he go again here?
Miracle's topped off. It's very difficult. Silence is not good for this when you can't whittle them down. Like, if you get silence and you're at full HP, you just stand there. You don't really care if you can't cast any of your spells because you're not going to die.
There's Miracle orbing the wave down again. Might be time to actually burn that clarity he's got. Yep, now he's got the space.
And interestingly enough, no obs wards for either side. Again, both players play pretty close to each other, and it's pretty easy to close the gap.
Don't think Miracle's actually got the money to really expend on an ops ward again. Phase shift, so he does manage to dodge the orb.
I think, sometimes you can get, like, level 2 phase shift, so you can actually sit in invulnerable during the entire duration of the orb, so that you don't get hit by it. So level 2 phase shift, you normally never pick up until, like, very late, like level, 4-4-1-1, so level 12, I would say, with 1 point in the talent. Mm-hmm. But in this matchup, might not be the worst thing in the world.
And watching Miracle trying, like, he actually commits his rift to get a last hit on a range creep. Like, this is the point he's at, but then the silence, paparazzi, that silence can last for a long time. Miracle doesn't want to stick around. He's going to ult jump himself away.
He has to be careful about that. If he has, like, cooldown on the orb, he can coil him, and as soon as he breaks it, he just throws a coil and just kills him. But you can see like how much guaranteed damage he can get because of the max level waning rift.
Yep.
This is becoming really intense. Miracle
keeps up the same.
Slightly behind in net worth, but he does have the HP advantage, but no mana. Not enough mana.
You actually wonder if he does have more, because he's gone for a 2-4-1 as opposed to Paparazzi with a 1-4-1-1. So Miracle currently has a little bit more burst damage in him if he wants to go like directly in.
That is true. Miracle can do more with less mana though, because he has higher levels of the main two spells that you're casting.
Yeah.
But level 8 versus level 7, almost level 8, but that one level difference is the Dream Coil that we see right now. Range Creep Deny. Oh, misses.
He might actually be able to go for the second one too. So denying up both the range creeps for Miracle, that works. So this matchup, again, remaining very close, even though it felt like Paparazzi was getting the advantage. Paparazzi seems to have a lot of kill plans for these 1v1s.
I don't think you're going to win by pushing the tower in this matchup.
No, you are not. But he's finding better positions, like that first little attempt he had over on Miracle, trying to force him almost into the battle.
Oh, see? If he had a level 2 face shield there, he would have kept his clarity. I don't know if it's worth it, but...
Now it's the other way around. There's your level 4 Silence Paparazzi. Where's that ultimate from him? He's going to let it go. It's actually Miracle who triggers his. Miracle is not a healthy man. And now they actually... Paparazzi will trigger... Did he cancel a salve on that?
Yep.
Oh, boy. At least Miracle's got a new one that just arrived. So he'll get his life back nice and quickly.
This is intense. I like this. What's the damage? 96. How much does Miracle have right now? He doesn't have a sec. Okay, they do have. So 96, 96. This might be talent time pretty soon. Generally, people will take the intel talent as opposed to health.
Oh, the jump
forward! My God.
Miracle with the damage the Silence will hold. He misses uphill, however. Miracle's gonna be so close to killing up Paparazzi, but he didn't get the hit uphill.
Drop the nose, please. Oh, that hurts my soul.
If you like me, you don't have one. Able to phase shift out. He's going to lose his own clarity, however.
I would like to see some item baits. Like you're dropping your nulls, forcing them to maybe come in and try and right click it. You waste some right click. You know, that's.
Like you wait for the nulls. You drop the nulls right to use your one charges. Miracle's walking around with 8 compared to Paparazzi 0 at the moment.
You think so, but some of these players just are not about that life. I don't know why. Maybe too much micro, but that's rarely a thing anymore.
Like all the efficiency.
Remember when Mushi refused this power or tread swap? That was crazy. It's like a T1 professional player that doesn't tread swap.
I remember when Malk would play offlane Nature's Prophet and refused to buy clarity.
I've tried to erase that from my memory, Toby. Don't remind
this
me.
Person on the panel, I'm fairly certain, can't erase that from his memory. Paparazzi now going to turn for the orb. Phase shift dodges from both sides. First silence is out, so you'll have to stand there and fight. But Miracle's going to have his up with a dream call. Miracle so low. Will it be enough? Yes, he will. The one touch will keep alive, but Paparazzi the sound. Miracle will still get it. He's able to connect with the orb, and we're going to a decider. That was beautifully close.
I want to see this replay.
Let's see that again.
There's no replay.
That's the standard game being played out. Woo. Wait, did he not GG?
Oh, he didn't GG.
Yeah, no, Miracle's going to keep fighting. He's like, good luck, good luck. Yeah, there is no GG. Paparazzi will not give up after the first kill.
He didn't take a talent. He went for level 4 orb and level 4 waning rift. 8 intel is pretty good, but 175 health is also pretty good. So because this tower is not in any...
I just assumed it was over after the first kill, but...
Yeah, well, Paparazzi disagrees. He disagrees with the world.
Just because every other one was like that. Paparazzi yep. seems like the... I don't know. If you're behind, do you get the health?
Wait, did he just afford... Okay, Miracle afforded the full treads. So treads are coming on the courier to Miracle at the moment.
Treads are rough. Right-click actually makes up a lot of your damage in this matchup.
But Miracle's got the money to celebrate as well. He does get the bonus. So Paparazzi needs to start doing damage control, repair things.
The net worth matchup was way worse than the last one, so he can still fight even despite this XP.
The jaunt forward coming right to the tower, phase shift.
So much HP though.
Yep.
With Strangers, he's at like almost 1200. With Paparazzi. Oh, the veil! Oh, no boots! Nice!
Really?
Kuni's
he's
going speed.
For the amplification?
He went for health. Okay, health I can kind of agree with because he's behind here. Mm-hmm. And you just need to not die a second time. That's how you lose.
Yep. And if he can get the kill on the Miracle as and like levels up, Miracle's actually going back. He could have triggered a shrine. Oh no, you can't use shrines. Yeah.
Something else about the Veil too is the 6 armor. So 6 armor can actually offset a lot of the damage from the right click from the treads. So he also went for health. Okay, double health.
But Veil though.
Yep. Helm of Vine Will is up, so we can have a quick look at this one little moment. The phase shift into salve.
That was actually... he didn't actually get the salve off before. It wouldn't have mattered. He still would have gotten crushed by that last orb. Melee range orb, impossible to dodge. Okay, so let's see this. Now Miracle surely scouts out the...
You get it like a cloak.
Oh, he just jumps in. The rift is actually out from Paparazzi. The orb will connect as well, but he won't want to stick around and fight.
That's a lot of damage.
It is, especially when Miracle didn't connect, but Paparazzi forced to stand on top of the tower. Dream Call versus Dream Call. All four Paparazzi. He'll actually jump out. Miracle jumping past the tower. He's still got a couple of stick charges up his sleeve. And Paparazzi, just with a fishing orb, wins out on the trade-off. There's still only 200, 300 net worth between these two.
5 armor is incredibly good.
It really is.
Versus 6. Yeah, he's actually not getting that low from the right clicks. And you have to right click him down at this point. The magic burst is only like 500 damage. And then Coil added, you know, maybe like just 550. With Veil, though, that number becomes quite significant.
Wondering how Miracle tries to do with
yeah.
it. He's looking at Veil himself.
Drop
now.
Those gnolls. Or backpack them, whatever.
Whatever works. Phase shift. Miracle still got hit by that as well as the silence. He needs to get back up the hill and away. Try to cancel the clarity of Paparazzi, but misses his attack thanks to the phase shift. And they're back even on net worth. The man who actually spills first blood is currently not winning. He's so far behind on CS.
The build too. This build is incredibly good. So if you burst them down, even with like 2 volleys of spells combining with a stick, that's probably only like 1,000 damage. So you still have to right click through like 1,400, let's say, with a lot of stick charges.
Mm-hmm.
So Veil complete.
That he does. Miracle needs to switch his items back in again, so the Veil will connect, but it's Veil more spam than anything else.
It's pretty good for pushing the tower down, too. You can one-shot the range creep with the orb after the Veil.
Oh, Miracle, there's your jump forward. There's no Veil buff up on this one, so Miracle will tank the damage. He's got orb as well as his dream call of his own. Has to, actually, he'll get the south canceled off. The quick jump away.
It was so important that he sticked before that. Now Paparazzi out of mana. He could go heal if he wanted to. That's a lot of mana to fill up. That's like 4 clarities.
Oh, Paparazzi, is he really going to stick around?
Paparazzi has
that?
No mana. He has no way to actually hit him. It's not like he can tread toggle. He has no boots.
Miracle's got his own regeneration coming out.
What's the mana regeneration looking at? 2.7 versus
6.8.
6.8 is only with the clarity. So 3.8 is what? 3 versus 2.7. I guess he gets a lot more from the 3.8. Yeah. Yeah. Interesting. Interesting. Mana regen.
Oh, yeah. The efficiency. Having to switch out, but it's the best way to do it underneath your own tower. You are in relative safety, and Paparazzi is not going to jump on you unless you want to try and have a crack at him. That'll cancel the clarity. So Miracle with a small advantage.
Could last a while. 17 minutes and counting.
Oh, that orb actually connected, and Miracle's going to jump forward. The silence this time as Miracle's doing it with the Dream Coil. Just extra damage into Paparazzi and forced him to just jump away. He is going to jaunt and takes the stun. Miracle could look for this one. If he wants to do it himself, the orb will fly forward. Paparazzi will dodge it. As you know, he goes in. He's right next to the Courier, and he'll take the Courier as well. Cancel the Clarity. Elder Doorbell will cut the orb. So while the kill will be traded back, Paparazzi will take that. He has no Courier for 2 minutes.
He wants to get to this wave, I believe. He has to go home and heal. There's just no way around it right now because he's not going to go home. He's actually going to pop his cell. So he can't ferry over Clarity. He can't ferry over Mangoes. Can't get a TP scroll to go back home.
Yep.
And he is going to just stand there and right click. The Veil build really paying off for him. The Courier kill is oftentimes
now he's going back.
But that's too much mana to refill.
He took the creep wave and then retreats. So there's a double creep wave. So when...
Dude, he's still dead.
Yeah. That's a long death timer, man. That's a lot.
Now he's like,
timer.
I want Vayle too. I bet he's gonna buy Vayle. He's like, no, I saw this guy.
Right. He was sitting on that quick buy for the last 5 minutes, but it's taking him this long to catch up. So at least he got the double creep waves. This is Miracle sniping the courier. Remember, he does get a little bit of extra cash from that, but when that orb connects from Paparazzi, there's just no way for Miracle to survive.
Uphill miss. Could have.
Potentially.
Oh, Wraithman. Okay, so he's going for the tower push. He didn't even fill up on mana. He really wanted to get that golden XP. So, yeah, it looks like Akila, he wants to actually go for the tower push. I have actually seen Dagon have some merit
Paparazzi
in this matchup.
He actually jumped in for that one. He's already connected on the Vayle, but the orb didn't connect, so now it's up to Miracle. He can join himself nice and safely away from the Radiant Creep Wave. Actually went into the river. Didn't get him up on the high ground, but it drags the Radiant Creep Wave a long way away. He just denied the rune because he was just there.
Yeah, why not? Extra style points.
It's not like it's SF where you get the extra soul for denying the rune.
You get style points though, Toby.
You do.
Hello.
Vayle connects. Phase.
Oh, clarity not even taken off. Perfect phase shift. Oh, actually, it's level 3 phase shift. What am I? Oh, he's like, why is he level 14?
Well, he soaked up the experience before he went back.
Okay, how about level 15 talent? What are we looking at?
Now the orb, Miracle able to get the silence and all of the last hits, so that's nice for him. He's getting very close to having the Helm of Iron Will. Okay, Dream Call commit. Enough to get secondary. And Miracle's gonna get Dream Call up. It's that nice to stop from having a real combo. The mana on him.
He might have to get about right now. Completed on that. So mana regeneration, look at 4.5 base. Without any clarity, Miracle only at 3.1. So, I mean, you're in lane for a really long time. It's been 20 minutes now.
Yep.
Oh.
Vayle, phase shift, able to dodge the orb, and Paparazzi's got nothing else to really follow up with, so there's no point jaunting.
No point at all. So, playing 20 minutes without boots is quite hard.
Here's Miracle's reinforcements. So the Helm of Iron Will finally comes out for him. He's got a salve, he's got a clarity. So he'll go back up to full, and now he'll probably be able to, like, not properly physically trade with Paparazzi, just because he's going to be worried about the magical burst with the buff from the Vayle, but it's a lot better for Miracle.
Yeah, he has the attack speed advantage, although Paparazzi will have the armor advantage.
Oh, Paparazzi's going to jump out, cancel your clarity. Puck, Miracle not looking too healthy, but Paparazzi still. Out of mana, no one charge is available, and Miracle has banked up 5 of his own.
This requires excellent chicken micro, by the way. That's pretty hard to ferry out yourself. Like, well, how many of thousands have you used this game? Like 25 or something?
It's a fair amount. Like, is it also like the prediction? Like, how much damage am I going to take? What play do I go for where I'm then willing to burn myself directly after? Miracle's actually getting pretty damn close to winning this by tower. Remember, there's two ways you can win this. It's 2 kills or the destruction of the tier 1 tower. That's down to 309. How's Miracle's actually looking? Because 309 on the Radiant side versus, okay, just over 1,000 for Miracle. He could win this by pushing the lane and taking the tier 1 tower.
That means Paparazzi can't go home and heal. He might have, maybe he can push out the wave and get a TP scroll. I don't know. I'm just looking for a way to refill his mana all the way right now, because it's just absurd that he can't actually cast Mango. Mango's too expensive. It's not cost efficient at all.
He may have no other choice if he's going to stay in the lane, because if Miracle does turn this into a push battle, and we start looking at Tau victory as the main win condition for Miracle, Paparazzi cannot leave.
He's looking pretty close to that. Yeah, he might just keep having to ferry out like 50 clarities in this game.
Just keep burning him, be very happy. You're like, okay, Miracle triggers it, fine.
You can backdoor the towers too. And also worth noting is that Glyph has not been used, as far as I know, this entire game.
Correct.
Glyph is actually kind of important.
And Glyph is allowed. Glyph is most definitely allowed. And now the Vayle is over on Miracle. So he's got that buff up, he's got the one charges available, but this is sort of like leveling the matchups. The only difference is the difference between the Trezd and the Aquila.
It's 176 damage? Oh, he has the level 15 talent. Okay. Yeah,
the plus 50 damage from Paparazzi?
Yeah.
Does Miracle, like, Miracle's still shy of it, but with that damage, he can actually put a hell of a lot of, like, well, grunt work into that tier 1 tower.
Especially if his Aquila's turned on. Miracle actually has to make a play kind of soon. His tower's getting whittled down constantly. How's the mana looking? 620 versus... Oh no, Miracle doesn't have enough mana to push out the lane. This could be a disaster.
It will be if that ult's able to connect the damage. He's going to orb away.
This is really bad. His tower might die right here.
He has to drag the creep wave down. Like, there's no other choice. The damage from Paparazzi is still hitting in hard, but Miracle can't really stop it. So he has to come out and properly contest Paparazzi. The towns are so close to each other
in life now. I have no idea how Paparazzi regained this much mana, but now, yeah, cloak to counter the Vayle, and we've seen some
cool item builds here. Miracle enough for two spells right now. Not even enough for the coil unless he salves, or sorry, he sticks. And right now, the wave
of Paparazzi. Miracle nice able dodge. To dodge the rift, but Miracle still in trouble. The Dream Call's going to trigger on him. He has to actually send it back towards Paparazzi, but with no pre-wave, he just calls it. He understands he doesn't have the positioning. The kill belongs to him. Paparazzi will take the 1v1 tournament here at DAC 2017.
That was actually quite the riveting comeback. After being down first blood, he still comes back to beat Miracle. Wow.
Never give
Dude,
up, never surrender.
What this a
is,
god.
This is why we don't have a concede button in Dota 2. Like, it just doesn't happen. And